Today we're going to talk about upholding precepts. Precepts are the foundation of Bodhi, which is enlightenment. Only if we sincerely withhold precepts can we transform ourselves into Buddhas. In the Shakyamuni Sutra, it says, collecting one's thought consists the precepts. From precepts comes samadhi. From samadhi comes wisdom. So precepts, samadhi, and wisdom. These three are inseparable and go hand in hand with each other. These are called the three non-flow of study. We must have precepts first. In this class, we will learn about 10 major Bodhisattva precepts from the Brahmanic Sutra. Number one, precept on killing. We cannot intentionally kill any living creature. That includes human, animals, and insects, because a bodhisattva always nurture a mind of great compassion and kindness. Killing is the very antithesis of compassion, so we cannot kill or harm any live creatures. Precepts are Buddha's way of protecting and safeguarding us. No killing is to protect us from short lifespan and sickness. Number two, precept on stealing. Do not take possession of anything that doesn't belong to you. That includes cheating on taxes, gambling, or getting government benefit that you're not supposed to have. You will lose it in other ways, such as fire, flood, government, thieves, or squandering children. They will take away what you're not supposed to have. There was a government official that was very noble, so he resisted on taking any bribery. After he retired, he lived in the third unit of a four-unit town home. One day there was a fire that burned down unit 1, 2, and 4. Miraculously, his unit was not damaged by the fire. Why is this? Because he is holding precept of not taking any briberies. So holding precept will always give you positive karma. Number three, precept on sexual misconduct. Adultery ruins families. Do not put yourself in a situation that you might be tempted or you tempting other. We want to be proper and righteous, then no one will come entice you. So it's all up to you to have the conviction to be loyal to your spouse. And for nuns and monks, they are forbidden to have any sexual activities because it's the root of life and death. Number four is precept on lying and false speech. This one is the most common to break because we lie a lot. It's either because we want to boast about ourselves, or we want to get some benefit for ourselves, or we want to cover up some mistakes. All these are bad intentions. Honesty is the best solution to everything. Number five is precept on selling alcohol. For the five precepts, the precept is no drinking of alcohol. But for bodhisattvas, drinking alcohol is actually a minor offense, but selling alcohol is major offense. Because for bodhisattva, most important is do not harm others. When you sell alcohol, you're harming others. When you drink alcohol, you are just hurting yourself. So that becomes a minor offense. So we do not want to sell any alcohol or give anybody wine or beer as presents to cloud their mind and prevent their innate wisdom. So we do not want to have any substance that will confuse us and make us deluded. Number six is precept on broadcasting the faults of the assembly. Bodhisattvas cannot gossip. If we keep saying the wrongdoing of monks and temples, how is Buddhism going to flourish? We can privately counsel others of their wrongdoing, but do not disclose it in public. When we publicly disclose the faults of others is because, number one, we are jealous of other people's accomplishment, or number two, it's out of anger, we want to punish them. Both of these are ill intentions and their afflictions. Bodhisattva always watch their thoughts and their intentions and do not break any precepts with their thoughts. Number seven is precept on praising oneself and disparaging others. So there's two parts to this precept. One is praising oneself, and the second part is disparaging other. When you do both of these, it becomes a major offense. Praising oneself is because of our arrogance. When we disparage others, it's because we have jealousy or we are greedy for other people's respect and offerings. A bodhisattva actually does the opposite. They actually disclose their own shortcomings and praise others of their good qualities. That way, they will give the glory to others and take the blame themselves. That is a true bodhisattva. Number eight, precept on stinginess and abuse. Bodhisattva always give. They're willing to give everything. So if we are stingy with money or dharma, that is all stinginess. Sometimes we might lie and say, oh, I don't have any money, or I don't know this dharma. When you do that, you've been stingy. And if you even scold them because you discriminate against them and think they don't deserve any money or dharma, that is even worse. That's called abuse. So when you do that, it breaks a major precept. Bodhisattva, they're afraid of causes. Mundane people are afraid of retributions. Bodhisattva, they always watch their thoughts. They don't want to have the cause of suffering because they want to leave suffering and leave samsara. Number nine is precept on anger and resentment. So number eight is greediness. Number nine is anger. Number 10 is ignorance. Bodhisattva means someone with great compassion, and anger is the opposite of compassion. This precept actually has two parts. One is being angry, two is holding grudges. Bodhisattva cannot do either of those. When other people apologize to us for their fault, we have to accept their apology and forgive them. We cannot hold any grudges against anyone. That is the precept. So refrain from being angry. Number 10 is a precept on slandering the triple jewels. This is ignorance when we slander the triple jewels. You say, how can we slander the triple jewel? We're Buddhists. A lot of time we do it without knowing it. For example, we might say, oh, just chant Obito Fo, we don't need to read any sutras. That is actually slandering the triple jewels because you are not respecting Shakyamuni Buddha's dharma. That's not what he meant when he introduced the Pure Land Buddhism. He wants us to hold precepts and study all the dharma and to know how to be enlightened. Purifying the mind is the meaning of Buddhism. So we need to purify our mind to go to the pure land, because a pure mind creates a pure land. So we make sure we know the correct dharma. Do not disclose the wrong dharma to anybody. Some people say the Shogama Sutra or Mahayana Sutra are not expounded by Buddha. That's also slandering the dharma. So we gotta be very cautious with what we say to prevent us from being ignorant and breaking this precept. All these precepts are to deal with a bodhisattva's own afflictions. Our reason of cultivating is to break our vexations and defilements. We must hold precepts to help us conquer our defilements. In conclusion, sentient beings on receiving the Buddha's precept join forth with the rank of Buddha. They are in essence equal to the Buddhas. They are the true offsprings of the Buddhas. So this is actually in the Brahmanet Sutra. It says when we receive the Bodhisattva precept, immediately we join the rank of all Buddha. We are in essence the same as all Buddha, and we are the sons of Buddha. So there's immense benefit by holding precepts, especially the Bodhisattva precept. Don't be afraid of holding precepts. They are not restraints for you. They're actually helping you to walk the path of Buddhahood. Every Buddha holds these precepts in order to reach Buddhahood. So we must follow the same path. Hold the precepts as brilliant gems. They are precious and valuable. We should be grateful that we can encounter the Dharma and hold the Bodhisattva precept. So don't be afraid. If you're afraid, it's like someone who wants to become a doctor but doesn't want to go to medical school. How are you going to become a doctor? So gladly hold the precept. It's a beginning to yourself reaching Buddhahood. So that's the class for today. Thank you for listening. Amitabha.